We continue our coverage of the man who will soon be working here at the state capitol. Tom Corbett will be inaugurated as the next governor next Tuesday.
But the man leaving that office, Governor Ed Rendell, still has a lot to say. And he sat down with 8 on Your Side government reporter Matt Belanger to look back at Rendell's 8 years in office and his biggest regret.
What would you tackle in 4 more years if you had them?
There's much more to be done. We need a stronger mandate for the use of renewable and alternative, the new green energy, because that's where the jobs are going to be in the next 15, 20 years, and continue to save money. The big unwritten story, Matt, is that we've saved almost $2 billion a year. This government today spends less money on its operation, on its overhead, than we did in 2002.
Can we talk about property taxes for a second? Sure. You brought gaming to Pennsylvania. What do you say to the people, to the homeowner that's looking at his or her bill, and that bill is still going up every year, albeit probably not as much as it would without gaming? What do you say to people who say it hasn't worked?
Well, first of all, for seniors, and if you go back to my 2002 campaign, it was seniors that I said needed property tax relief the most. It's worked big time. 120,000 zeroed out and another 110,000 cut by more than 50%. Those are impressive numbers. For the rest of us, it averages about $180, $200. It'll be more once we get all the venues up and running. So has it turned back property taxes? No, but the rate of increase is substantially less than it would have been.
Rendell says he'd like to see gaming expanded even more, like his failed plan to legalize video poker machines to support education.
If there's an illegal poker machine, video poker machine in a bar, well, there's gambling going on, and the taxpayers aren't getting any benefit from it.
One regret, and only one regret. What's the biggest one you have?
Well, it's signing the pay raise. You remember, the year before I signed the pay raise, I turned down the legislature's request for a pay raise. I should have used my judgment, which was better than the legislature's, and said no, and I should have protected them against themselves.
As for incoming governor, Republican Tom Corbett, Rendell's advice is to be flexible.
It's a disgrace that the legislature reneged on its promise to pass a shale tax before the end of the year. And Governor Corbett has said no to any new taxes and has said no to a shale tax. I hope he will reconsider. This idea that all government spending is bad is ruinous for the country. Government spending that's wasteful, government spending that doesn't achieve its goal, government spending that's directed at things that aren't important, that's bad government spending. But government spending on state police, it's not bad. Government spending to help protect our troops in Afghanistan and Iraq, that's not bad. Government spending to make sure we have safe roads and bridges, that's not bad. The public has to learn to distinguish between good government spending and not so good government spending.
One of the options talked about to make this budget balance moving forward, and this probably wouldn't even fill the entire hole, but it's privatizing the wine and spirits stores. What's your take on that?
It would be a mistake to use the money from privatization to fill the budget hole. And let's assume we got $1.5 billion for selling the liquor stores. Well, if you put that $1.5 billion in this year to plug the budget gap, what happens next year? Next year, that $1.5 billion hole is still there, and you haven't really accomplished anything. You've just delayed the day of reckoning for a year.
As for Rendell's future plans, he says he's looking forward to being paid to deliver some speeches. He's been giving them for free for a number of years now. He also is writing a book. He's on chapter 12 of 30. He tells me of that book. He'll probably appear on a cable network as a Democratic voice, a pundit. And he continues to teach at Penn in Philadelphia.
No doubt we haven't heard the last of Ed.
Ed Rendell will still, let's be honest, be making headlines for a long time to come.
And he still does his football announcing, too.
That's right. He's a long
time. A lot going on. A beautiful wife. He has a lot of things to do. Thank you.
Thanks, Matt.